Beginner's Guide to Email Marketing in Kartra. Okay, so you're wanting to start to send emails in Kartra, but you have no clue where to begin. Well, you're going to want to watch this video to the very end, because I'm going to take you from a real beginner to setting up your first emails in this one video, and we're starting right now. Hey, I'm J.R. Fisher. I've been selling online since 2009. I've sold millions of dollars worth of both digital and physical products, and I learned a few things along the way. As a matter of fact, I have my branded products on thousands of websites, including Walmart. So we've done a lot of sales. Now on this channel, what I basically do is I just show you what we did to make these sales. Okay, so I teach you how to start, run, and grow your online business. And I also want to give you another bonus. In the description below, I have a $97 e-commerce course. You can get absolutely free. All you have to do is click the link and watch it. No credit card required. Now, I want to hear, have you done any email marketing already? Put your comments below. I want to hear what you've done, where you've done it, the results you've gotten, and also if you have any questions, feel free to put those questions in there. I'll be happy to answer them. All right, let's get started. First thing you want to do if you're brand new here is to subscribe to my channel. Okay, that's super important. You know, if you haven't subscribed yet, you're going to miss out on some really good stuff. So go down there, hit that subscribe button. Now next to it, there's a little bell. You want to click on it, ring the bell. And once you do that, you want to turn on all notifications. That way you become part of my family, the Fisher family, the VIP group that knows about these videos way before anybody else, because I can actually notify you when you do that. Super important. All right, let's jump right into this. Let's get into Kartra and let's look at the way that we're going to send emails inside of Kartra. I gotta tell you, I've been doing this since 2009. I've used a lot of different pieces of software, and by far, Kartra does more for our business than anything else. When we switched over to Kartra, we actually canceled 8 different pieces of software because Kartra did all those things for us. So if you've already got Kartra, great. If you don't, there's a link below. You can watch a video. It's free. You don't need a credit card to watch the video. And once you've watched the video, if you do want to get a trial of Kartra, you can actually get one for just $1. Now, before I started sending emails, I got Kartra all set up, and I'm going to tell you, you want to do that. You know, you want to, you know, set up all your lists in there. You want to establish your payment integrations. You want to do all the stuff that you need to do to set up your Kartra account. I'm not covering that in this video. We're just covering emails, but I'm assuming that you've got all that done, because you don't want to send emails out if they click and they can't go to a page and nothing works. Okay, so make sure you get all that set up first. Now, once I did that, of course, I set up my pages where they could click on it and they actually goes to a page and there's actually a product there and they can actually buy that product. So you have to have that done before you set up these emails, because you're going to have them click and go somewhere. Now, I say that, but that's only if you built it in Kartra. If you're sending them to like a WordPress website or Magento or Shopify, then you don't have to worry about that. You can just put that link in there and send them to that page. Now, you want to start with your leads, okay? So before you can even send an email in Kartra, you need somebody to send it to, somebody to receive it. So you can upload those to Kartra, and they have a little bit of a lag, maybe a day or two before they're actually going to approve them, but you can just upload all your leads to Kartra. And then don't forget to tag them. You know, you may have different products, you may have different businesses. I know I have a couple different businesses in there, so we have those people categorized in there so the emails go out to the right people. So make sure you're setting up all your tags, you've tagged them properly, buyers, non-buyers, people who downloaded stuff, that type of thing, and you have all that set up first. That way you'll have all that done when you go to send your email. You can send it based on those tags, because you're going to need to do that. Now, if you need to collect leads, you can also do that in Kartra. I'm not covering it in this video, I'm covering emails, but you can set up opt-in forms in Kartra and you can actually start building your email list. And once you build it and they opt in Kartra, they automatically get put on lists, so you don't have to worry about that. It's an automatic thing. Now, before you send these broadcasts, before you send these emails, make sure if you're uploading your own list that you do it at least a day or two in advance, so that they're there when you want to send it out, because there is that lag before they actually go into the system. Now, you may find this irritating, and I get it, but it's really super important, because Kartra is worried about deliverability. And if they don't go through these lists and make sure they're done properly, then your emails aren't going to get delivered. So we want to make sure that that is done and they're actually doing that for your benefit. I'm going to send a broadcast. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to my campaign. So let's take a look at that real quick. It's on the left-hand side, and then you tap campaigns at the very top of the page, and then you select broadcast below. So you can see that there. Once on the correct page, I simply tap the green plus button, and that green plus button is going to be on every single one of your Kartra pages when you're starting out. So, you know, whether you're building a sales page, whether you're doing email sequences, whatever, you'll always have that green plus button. So that's where you want to start off at. So then Kartra is going to take you to another page, and it's going to have your automations, your send, your schedule, and all your finishes and all the things you need to do. Let's go over and take a look at that. Now I'm going to choose to send my message through an actual email. You can also send it through an SMS, which means it's going to go to people's phones. You're going to need to use something like Twilio or Nexmo or Tropo or something like that, and you're going to have to integrate it if that's what you're going to do. The next part you're going to come to is the send from area. This is actually the email that they're going to see that it actually came from, and should they respond, they'll actually respond to this email too. Once you build your email list within Kartra, you can choose who it's going to go to. You're going to get this drop down, and you can choose, you know, all types of different things. If you don't have your list really built that much yet, and you want to send it to everybody in the database, then you're going to click, I'm going to show you on the screen here real quick, you're going to click where it says everybody in my database, but you can also click on has opened email, has not opened email, that type of thing. Now the cool thing is Kartra is actually going to tell you how many leads you selected once you did that, so you're going to know up front how many people it's going to go off to. Now here's a screenshot of that. It says 5 leads selected, 5 emails filled in, none of them are blocked, and 5 total to send. So before you send, you're going to know how many emails are going to actually go out. Now the next thing you can do is A/B split test. So, you know, you can have 2 different emails going out dependent upon what you want to send. You know, maybe you want to test one message in one, different message in the other one. Now I will tell you, when you're testing, you only want to test one variable. So maybe it's the headline because you're trying to increase open rates, but the email is identical. If you change the headline and the email, you're not going to know, you know, which email is better. If you have the same exact email and 2 different headlines, you're going to know which headline got them to open it more than the other one. So make sure you do that. Now you can also toggle between basic and advanced. Now when you do that, that's going to give you some different options. Now don't forget, you got to have links in those emails. When you're sending those emails out, the whole point is to get them to click and go somewhere and do something, whether it's a download, whether it's to read your blog, whether it's to buy a product. So don't forget to put those in every single email. Now once you do one email, then you do your other email, maybe changing the headline so that you can test the difference in those headlines. Now, if you go into the advanced setting on these emails, you can actually change components like templates for your emails in there, and colors and backgrounds and that type of thing. Here's a screenshot of what that looks like, and you see you have design templates right there. You have full templates, my templates. So it gives you that added feature right there. Now here's an example of one of the emails here and some of the things that you can do with it. And if you notice, you know, the font really stands out well here because the background color is different. And you can do a lot more with it if you're in the advanced. Now there are schools of thought that say, well, you know, emails should be basic. They should look like every other email they get from their friends and that type of thing. We tend to use just black text on a white background, and I'll put some images in there every now and then, but those seem to convert better for us than anything else. These take a lot more time to build ones like this, but if that's what you want to do, you can certainly do that in Kartra. Now one thing you want to be careful about is don't click the X or delete button in the email editor. Unlike building pages and other things in Kartra where you can just hit the go back button, once you click delete, it's gone. You can't go back, so you're going to lose everything you worked on. I've written my 2 emails. Does that mean I can go ahead and send them now? No, not quite. Because what we have to do now is decide what percent of these emails are going to go to one group versus the other group. The percent has to add up to 100%. So, you know, maybe you want 50-50 split. Maybe you're really concerned that this one email is not going to do well, so you only want to put 10% in that, and you would have put 90% in the other one. Either way, you got to make that decision at this point. What is the percentage of split? Now, if you're using any type of dynamic variables, and what I mean by that is it changes each time an email goes out. So I may have dear and then put in first name right there, and it's going to fill in John or Bob or Becky or whoever it is. When you send out your test email, which you should every single time, it's going to say dear test in that particular area right there. So keep that in mind. Now, once you play around with Kartra a little bit and you see what an automation is, you're going to understand that, but you got to get in there and kind of work with it a little bit. I know initially when I looked at it, I'm like, what the heck is that? What does that mean? But now I know it and I understand it. So it just takes some time, and don't quit, you know, just keep working on it. You'll get this stuff. I know it seems foreign to you, but it only seems foreign to you because you haven't done it. Once you've done it a few times, it's going to seem very commonplace. So number one, I can set up an automation to go out to people who have not opened my emails after 100 hours, okay? I can send them a whole different email that may make them more likely to open it. Maybe I can change a subject line, do something along those lines. So those automations are really helpful for cleaning up your list and getting people to open your emails when they're not opening them. Now you can also break these into lists. So number two is, if a lead has actually opened my email, I may add them to another list because I know these people are interested in my product or services. Now here's an example right here. You don't have to do this, but you probably should. It's a helpful way to further segment your leads by setting up these automations. So you can see here, we've got a couple things set up, early holiday painting announcement within 100 hours. If, you know, the lead does not open that particular one, then subscribe the lead to the list ignored email, okay? And then we have some different emails that go out on that. And then the second one says, if lead opens email, early holiday painting announcement, okay? Subscribe them to the list opened email, and then we can send them a different automation. Now at this point, everything's set up. I can go ahead and get ready to send out my emails. Now the cool thing with Kartra is I can set it up to go out right now. I can schedule it for another day. Now keep in mind, the way the time works in Kartra is it's always set on Eastern Standard Time. So if you're on the West Coast like we are 3 hours behind them. So, you know, if I want to send an email at, you know, 12 noon, I'm going to need to send it for 3 p.m. in the afternoon. It's all going to be set on Eastern Time, so you can do that. And the last thing you can do is if you're working on an email and you're not ready to send it, you to do some more stuff to it, you can just save it as a draft. Now the cool thing is, once you've sent 10 broadcasts in Kartra, it will start to suggest to you the best time of day and week and month of when to send out your emails. That's a good overview on the emails. I will tell you, there's a lot more to learn in Kartra. I have a lot of videos on this channel that are going to teach you those things, but that's a good starter right there. You got to start sending emails. You got to start making money. Now, if you enjoyed this video, do me a favor, subscribe below if you haven't done so. Don't forget, turn on notifications, click that bell and turn on all notifications. You become part of the VIP people. That's right, the Fisher family. And you will be notified in advance when I do a video or when I go live. Also, don't forget to put your comments below. What did you like about this video? What did you dislike about this video? What do you want to know about? You got a question? I'll be happy to answer it for you. Put your comments below. Don't forget to do that. Also, I have a free $97 value e-commerce course below. All you have to do is click and learn. You can get access to that, and you don't even need a credit card. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one. Hey, thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click that little bell right here so you can be notified every time I do a new video. Also, click on one of those videos there. Keep watching on my channel.